Vekoma is a Dutch roller coaster manufacturer. They are known for making many clones of their coaster models and making extremely rough and painful rides. However, lately Vekoma has been enjoying an astounding resurgence. They have built 3 new models of coasters in just the past 6 years, and even more are coming in 2020 and 2021, such as the Firestorm and Shockwave. But what causes this sudden greatness, and will the company continue moving in this direction? To answer that, let's look at some information. First off, let's take a look at some of the newer Vekoma coasters and models. The Vekoma Suspended Family Coaster is a model that has greatly progressed since the original installation. In 2001, two of these family-oriented coasters were built, one at Canada's Wonderland and the other at Ohio's Kings Island. These rides are known in the enthusiast community for being ridiculously rough and shaky. They also have over-the-shoulder restraints, meaning that the roughness is magnified by the headbanging. However, in 2013, Vekoma built something new. Farup Summerland in Denmark would receive this new and improved suspended coaster, and there it received very positive reviews for being an intense ride with good restraints. Since then, this family coaster has been cloned all over the world, proving its success. Even after Arcanon, Vekoma has installed more new coasters. Lek Coaster at Legendia in Poland is the only operating Bermuda Blitz at the time of recording, and it too has received rave reviews, along with the launch coaster Formula at Energylandia, also in Poland. All of these coasters are said to be very smooth as well, unlike the original suspended looping coaster and boomerang models. Besides that, the ride comfort has greatly improved. While they do still have over-the-shoulder restraints, they have vastly improved from the old ones. These new restraints are really just slap bars with vests, make it impossible to get any kind of headbanging, even with some very strong forces. So now I've talked a bit about Vekoma's past and what new and improved coasters they've made, but now let's see how they got there. First of all, the company developed a new style of design software, which has allowed engineers the ability to make smoother rides with better transitions. According to Vekoma, they use detailed risk analysis, FEM calculations, and multi-body analysis. A new head designer, Benjamin Bometel, was also added to the Vekoma team to utilize this technology. This man is behind the Space Warp, Bermuda Blitz, Shockwave, and Firestorm models, along with every other new Vekoma concept. Adding on to this, Vekoma has production facilities for trains in the Netherlands, Eastern Europe, and China, all said to have the most modern production and testing equipment. This is to suit any destination the buyer might be located in and any need they might have. Vekoma offers many options for spare parts and reconditioning according to the company, meaning that the customer will always have a reliable choice with Vekoma. All of these things make Vekoma sound extremely convincing. And not only does it sound good, it is good, as shown by the previously mentioned Lek Coaster and Formula. Europe clearly believes this as well, since they are getting many new kinds of Vekomas. In 2020, we will even be seeing the world's first launched flying coaster at Fantasialand, and of course, it will be made by Vekoma. The company is even becoming so trusted that Rocky Mountain Construction, more commonly known as RMC, is using them to support their Europe market. So do I think Vekoma is on the road to greatness? Absolutely I do. Before we know it, I expect to see more of Vekoma's great new creations pop up as their old models disappear and fade from people's memories. Despite the rough start and still being criticized to this day for their past, I believe that Vekoma has and will continue becoming a very successful company, and they have a great future ahead of them. Anyways, that's going to do it for this video. If you enjoyed, please make sure to like the video, and of course subscribe if you are new, and I will see all of you guys next time. Bye.